Memphis makes a national list we can actually be proud of, believe it or not. The Bluff City has landed in the top 10 on Movie Maker Magazine's list of the best places to live and work as a filmmaker.
And we'll take it. Well, Memphis and Shelby County Film Commissioner Linn Sitler is here with movie maker Brad Ellis. Good morning, you guys.
Hey, how are you?
What is up with this list? We're excited to be on it. We need to be on more lists.
Oh, yes. Well, actually, this is the fourth year in a row that we've made this list.
Awesome.
Yes, and this year it was because of course, Sun Records leaving $6-7 million direct spend in the economy, and also our wonderful independent film community represented here by Brad. And, you know, and just even the Harahan Bridge, they've got excited about and put in their article.
Which is right next door to WREG.
I know.
Yeah. So, Brad, from a filmmaker, from a movie maker standpoint, what do you feel this city is doing right these days?
Everything.
I mean, everything.
The community has just blossomed. You know, I've been doing this for almost 18 years, born and raised in Memphis, and I can't imagine, you know, making movies in any other city. With everything the Film Commission's doing, Indie Memphis, just a plethora of activities and organizations that are really bringing the city to life.
And the venues have really increased, and the level of where you can show your films after everything gets done has
Absolutely.
Really, I mean, the bar has stepped up high
now. It's not just a one and done kind
right.
of thing. Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you excited about that? I mean, you're being able to take it everywhere?
I mean, yeah, it's to me, it's in 10 years, I can't wait to see, you know, where we're going to end up, because it does keep growing.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you said, it's not just a one-stop, one-platform kind of thing now. It's so many
Multiple.
More eyeballs mm-hmm. are seeing your films.
So, Linn, obviously, it seems like the city of Memphis is doing a lot of things right. What else do we need to do? What else would you like to see? Because before this interview started, we saw you talking with some of the state lawmakers
about, grabbing them, wasn't I?
About incentives and what have you. What are your thoughts on that? What do we need to do to make even more films here?
Well, we, you know, are in talks continually, quite frankly, with the state film commissioner and Senator Mark Norris mm-hmm. about ways to improve our incentive and make it not only available to the bigger budgeted clients like Sun Records, Million Dollar Quartet, mm-hmm. but also to lower the incentive threshold. You have to, you know, have a certain amount of in-state spend before you can apply for the incentive. And so that would make the incentive available to the independent filmmakers that usually have smaller budgets. Mm-hmm. So we're talking with them quite a bit about both of those items.
Because when you're an indie filmmaker, I mean, it's all about cost. It's the bottom line. And you're like, how many friends can I get on this that I'm not going to be able to pay you, but I need you in this film?
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, and it's... That's why having people like Linn and Sharon at the Film Commission, mm-hmm. I mean, you pick up the phone and call them, and they can get you just about anything that you need.
No doubt about it.
It's legal.
Yeah, it's legal. We're glad you emphasized that, Linn. We were just looking at a trailer from Sun Records.
I know, it's hard
for me. About to say Million Dollar
right.
Quartet. When we have a production like this, and a lot of times we can now kind of base things on the success that we saw with the TV show Nashville mm-hmm. in Nashville, Tennessee, mm-hmm. of course. What can we possibly get from a movie, from a production TV series like Sun Records? What can that do for the city as a whole?
Well, it provides jobs and also learning opportunities for the crew and for the cast. And as a matter of fact, we're going to host a workshop about auditioning, because we've got a lot of talent in Memphis, a lot of acting talent along with the crew, but the acting talent doesn't necessarily know how to audition, and I heard that from the clients. So, but hopefully they'll come back, and for season two, hopefully there will be a season two, and when they come back, we'll have our people a little better prepared to try out and be able to show their talent. Sometimes you can be the most talented actor in the world, but if you don't know how to audition, you don't get the job. And so we're talking about jobs, we're talking about the hotels booming, talking about the bars booming. We're talking about everything, but also with this particular, it showcases Memphis history and Memphis music, and that's why Kevin Kane and Regina Bearden at the Tourism Bureau are so excited, and we all are, because this is really going to boost tourism. It respects our music history, and it's jobs.
Looks very cool for sure. Brad, Linn, thank you very much. And by the way, Sun Records debuts on CMT sometime, I think, the latter part of February.
February
23rd.
There'll be watch parties all over town.
No doubt about it. Thank you guys very much. Congratulations.
Thank you.